Yo guys, what is up? It is Nick. We are back on Dark Souls 3, the Ring City DLC, and we are going to finish it up today. Still playing with my friends, helped one already complete the final boss here, Slave Nightgale, as well as help both of them beat the dragon boss. So we're still co-oping for fun tonight, and so I decided just to go ahead and beat it on this playthrough. I probably should have just gotten on another character to play with these guys, but I'll try to speed run through the DLC, and maybe I'll do a little extra little solo on both of the bosses, just for you guys. And maybe I think I'm going to do just a fun run through on my, I believe it's my Princess Reject or something. I don't know exact name, but it's a 150, solo 150, and I believe it's still on regular new game. And I believe it's like a Lightning Blade Goddard Twin Swords build. I believe that's what it is, so we will go ahead and do that. This video will probably be chopped up into a few different pieces. There's a few different areas that I need to show, hopefully with all commentary, but we've got this little intro, and then we'll have the boss. And then I believe there's an NPC fight after you beat the boss. And then I think there is also, there's the talking to the girl in the Ashes of Ariandel DLC. There's talking to that, and then I believe there might be one more thing for me to do, so this video may be chopped up and then edited together. Don't edit together a lot of videos or edit out stuff, because they're mostly just live comms and that's how I roll, but this one may be chopped up a little bit and edited, because otherwise, you gotta sit through all the loading screens, and you gotta sit through all the stuff like that, but I think that's what's gonna happen. We're going to take on the final boss, and all different stuff like that, and finish up the DLC, but this won't be the end of the Dark Souls 3 content on my channel. I love Dark Souls, and even though this is it for it, I can still do some content and stuff like that on the DLC, but that is going to do it for the little intro part here. We'll be back in just a second to take on the final boss. And so I will catch you all then. Alright guys, we are back and it's time to take on the final boss. So let's hop right into this. Alright, let's do this. What? You're a special type of... You're an idiot. Alright, I'm going in. Reminds me of like, oh, I forget the name of the boss. The boss that runs on all fours, just like, oh, it reminds me of Vort. Vort had that weird movement on four limbs. German. The moon presence. The moon presence? Oh. Yeah. Because I was interested in it. I'll probably buy a PS4. When Bloodborne 2 comes out, because there'll be enough games on PS4 I haven't played that I'll want to play. Oh. It'll be a Bloodborne 2 will be a PS4 exclusive. I'd be excited. Ow. I feel like he has more health on my regular new game. I feel like he's taking less damage on my regular new game plus than he was on Josh's. Oh yeah, cause he... Okay. Now he spawns with all the way across the map from us. Really liked this boss. I wish it was two staged. And the second stage was the Dark Soul coming out of him. And being its own fight. You can also get the repeating crossbow. Oh no. Alright, Papa Gale. Papa Gale, stop being aggroed on me. Oh my god. Alright, let me great heal. I kinda saw it when I was healing myself. It's always nice when a boss misses. Here comes the lightning. Was he shooting his crossbow from midair? Well, I need it. Oh my! I'll just heal myself. Okay. That is nice that those black circles indicate the lightning. Not just a random ass drop. I'll try to. I got a aggro. And once he gets aggroed, he is aggroed on you. He's supposed to be like a fast boss and all that stuff. He's going. Oh god. Coming, Josh. That's how I died on Josh's. He has that weird double hit. It like counts it as a double hit, but it's really not a double hit. Yeah. Oh look, Josh is about to die. I'm about to... Oh my gosh, I hate that attack! Screw you, Gale! Harder to hit him with these sunlight spears than it should be. Almost got him. I hate that when he starts up that wind up at one player and then switches it around. Like that. What the? Oh god! I died right now. I'm so heated. And he's dead! I have to get my extra souls. Soul of Slave Nightingale and Blood of the Dark Soul. It's like habit. It does, the guy got like 380,000 souls out of it. I do like how it just ends. There's no cutscene ending, it just ends. No, we got Troy still. I'm gonna go kill Shira. You said she's in a random building off to the right or left? As I go back to the bonfire? That's some confusing shit, Josh. I'm just gonna run around and see if I can find Shira. Is it like, I think I found it, but I'm not sure. Is it like the starting? Oh wait, hold on. I think this is it. But Shira wasn't there for me to summon, so there's like a high probability she's not here. Okay, that was the wrong way. I can't find the bell. Is it like a big Coliseum looking area, Josh? Yeah, Shira's not here.
I've
Like,
searched
it's.
for thee,
Oh, wait, 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 wait.
dark, stricken creature. I am Shira, daughter of the Duke, descendant of gods, and trusted friend to Medea. At once, I am the honor of the gods, the glory of fire, and the fear of the dark. Thou shalt not go unpunished for thy treachery, thy profanity, and thy shameless yearning.
Yes, I got her. I was listening to the dialogue. You know, this is kind of bad. I've got like no Estus. Ow! I got a bunch of Ashen Estus, which isn't really gonna help. Oh my gosh, he hit like a truck! God, she's got some crazy poise. Oh my gosh. Josh, how many Estus Flash did she have? She keeps healing! Wait, she doesn't follow you outside of the room? Oh my gosh, she healed again. Oh, she's out. Alright, Shira. Would you die, please? Oh, one more hit. Crucifix of the Mad King. It's a cool weapon. A cool name. I'm gonna head back to Firelink and then we'll do the boss fight for Troy. I'm gonna do one thing. Alright, so now it's time to read a couple of item descriptions and then call it an episode, or actually call it until we go to Ashes of Ariandel. So, first of all, we've got, do we have any armor? Oh, okay, we got the antiquated plane garb. Ordinary garb from an ancient land of sorcery, the gold embellishments betray a faint residue of magic, but this clothing was never intended for battle. When a mission visited the Ring City long ago, one of its younger missionaries elected to stay behind. It was he who became the last recorded spear of the church. Okay. Violet wrappings. These arm wrappings, sewn with violet cloth and embroidered with gold thread, were intended for everyday use, yet they served well enough in many a battle in wreathing the arms of one who would go on to embrace the sword. Alright, so that all. Okay, that's all the armor. What new weapons? We have obviously the one I just picked up. Crucifix of the Mad King. Only 19 strength, that's not that high a requirement. A cross spear hung with a malformed corpse. Once a mad king was born to the pygmy royalty, and Shira, knight of Filianor, put him to rest. But Shira's cross spear, unable to kill the undying king, only pinned itself to him. Shira delivered them together to a dark room where she stayed and held them close. Skill, mad king's folly. Slam malformed corpse into the ground to briefly awaken it, then fill A with strong attack to trigger a roar, a blessing, or a vexation. So that's either a yell. I don't know what the blessing would be. I think a vexation is a negative. Like, I think it does damage to you or something like that. So now we have a couple of boss weapons to look at. First of all, we have Soul of Dark Eater Midir, the Old Moonlight. A memory of an old sword found deep within Midir. This sorcery uses souls to grant form to the thought and attack with it. Attacks are coupled with light waves and sustaining the stance before attacking increases their speed and potency. The sword is named after Moonlight, but it is slightly different from the one fashioned of the Pale Drake Seath. Perhaps it is rooted in an older memory from not long after the beginning. So, like a predecessor of Seath, what I'm getting from that. Next we have... here we go. Gale's Greatsword. Greatsword of Slave Knight Gale, the only weapon that he kept with him from beginning to end. Originally an executioner's sword made for decapitation, this blade is heavily chipped and stained with the blood of countless battles. Skill, Blade of Peril. A precarious technique unique to undead Gale. Leap in any direction, slamming the greatsword to the ground, then follow with normal attack or a large spinning slash or strong attack to backstep and jump forward in an overhead slam. That's cool. Anything else? Okay, Slave Knight Gale, repeating crossbow. This crossbow, customized for repeating fire to face mobs alone, was wielded by Slave Knight Gale. Used in the battles of an endless journey, this crossbow is covered with twists and dinks, rusted with blood, and made extremely brittle from overuse. Skill, repeat fire. Assume a stance to activate repeat firing mechanism and repeat fire with normal and strong attacks. I think there's a katana that I missed, but I'm not seeing it. Oh, here we go. Frayed Blade, a dragon weapon symbolizing Dark Eater Midir. The once exquisite blade is now sustained back, black, and frayed at the hilt. Without its sheath, it will soon crumble into nothing. Skill, Hold. Assume a holding stance in which a normal attack sends a shockwave along the earth, and a strong attack commences a series of slashes. So I'll probably end up picking up one of those, but I don't know which one I'll pick up, so I'm not going to do it yet. You also, if you go back to the very beginning, that old hag you talked to at the very beginning drops her ashes. I accidentally gave them here, and I don't actually see anything unique that you get for giving the ashes here. I was hoping that maybe you could get that dress that Filianor has, but you can't. And it actually doesn't even look like there's anything special extra that you get. I was hoping that maybe there would be at least a spell or something extra for going back there and grabbing her ashes, but there isn't. If there's anything I'm missing, someone please let me know, but I don't think I am. So that is going to do it, guys. I'll stop by Ashes of Ariandel, and that will wrap up the episode. I'll give a little recap and all that different stuff, but I'll see you guys in the Ashes of Ariandel.